Hello and welcome to my channel all about accountancy, where we convert your accounting problems into solutions. I am your host, Professor Tanmay Kesarkar, and today I am back with the last episode of Subsidiary Books. Yes, we have come to the end of this series. From my next video, I am going to start a new series. So today, in the last episode of Subsidiary Books, I am going to talk about a journal proper. So if you remember, in the last videos I had mentioned that a journal proper is like the other section of the subsidiary books. So all the transactions which cannot be included into the cash book, purchase book, sales book, purchase return book and sales return book are to be entered into the journal proper. A journal proper is very easy to understand because its format and the method of solving the sum is exactly the same as it is for a journal. So if you are familiar with the chapter journal, you should know how to pass journal entries into a journal proper. In short, any credit transaction which is not related to goods will go into the journal proper. So without any further ado, let us directly look into the illustration that we are going to do today. So we are going to do this sum today. So let us read the question. Make a journal proper in the books of Bertha Limited. So in the heading I am going to write journal proper of Bertha Limited, and then we will draw the format. So I have written the heading and I have also made the format. The format is exactly the same as it was for a journal. So we have a date column, a particulars column, LF, debit and credit. So the entire logic of passing the journal entries also remains the same. So without wasting any time, let us get directly into the sum. So the first transaction is 2018 January 1. Started business with cash 30,000 and furniture 10,000. So I am starting business with cash and furniture. So actual journal entry is cash account debit, furniture account debit to capital. But I cannot record cash over here because I am making a journal proper. There is a difference. If it would have been a journal, I would have recorded a combined entry. But as I am making a journal proper, I cannot consider the cash component. So I will only record the furniture component over here. So for January 1, I have written furniture account debit to capital account. I have completely ignored the cash concept. And the furniture was of rupees 10,000 only. So my capital is also only 10,000 rupees. You don't have to write the entire capital because this entry has to be split up. One entry will go into the cash book, that is the cash component, and the other component, that is the furniture component, will stay in the journal proper. Clear? It is very easy, don't get yourself complicated. Just look into that transaction as if they are two separate transactions. Then you will get a clear picture. We have to also write narrations for this. So the narration is going to be, being business started with furniture. Moving on to the next transaction, January 6th, sold furniture to Link on credit rupees 5000. So I am selling the furniture to Link on credit. Cash is not involved, goods are not involved. So it will come into the journal proper without any doubt. So to pass a journal entry for this transaction, we have to find out the two aspects. So the first aspect is furniture that we are selling, and the second aspect is the receiver of the furniture, who is Link. So Link is the receiver, hence I will debit Link's account, and furniture is going out, hence I will credit the furniture. Clear? So I have written Link's account debit to furniture account 5000. Narration. Being furniture sold to Link on credit. Moving on to the next transaction, January 12th, purchase goods for cash rupees 6500. Now this transaction will not come over here because first of all goods are involved and secondly cash is involved. So this is going to go into the cash book. So I am not going to make any entry over here, it will go into the cash book. Moving on to the next transaction, January 17th, goods distributed as free samples 2500. Now, goods are involved over here, but am I purchasing them? No. Selling them? No. Purchase return, sales return? No. Which means it has to come over here only. because it cannot be entered into the four books and cash is not involved, so it cannot go into the cash book as well. So this entry is actually an advertisement entry. When do I want to distribute my goods as free samples? When I want to promote my goods. Hence, the journal entry for this is going to be advertisement account to goods slash purchase account. As goods account do not exist in accountancy, we have to write purchase account over here. So I will debit the advertisement account because it is actually an expense, right? And all the expenses are to be debited. Hence, advertisement account is debited. The narration for this is being goods distributed as free samples. Moving on to the next entry, January 25, goods destroyed by fire, rupees 3000. Now again, am I purchasing these goods? No. Selling them? No. Purchase return, sale return? No. Is there any cash involved in this? No. That means this transaction has to be entered over here into the journal proper. Now my goods are getting destroyed by fire, so it is my loss. Hence I will debit the loss. So loss by fire account is going to be debited, and as the goods are going out of my organization because they are getting destroyed, I have to credit the goods. That is, I have to credit the purchase account. Now please do not confuse purchase account with purchase book. There is a huge difference between them. So let us write the journal entry. So I have written the date 25th. Loss by fire account debit because I have suffered a loss and the losses are to be debited. To purchase account, that is to goods account, because the goods are getting destroyed, that is they are going out of my organization, and the amount of my loss was 3000. The narration for this is being goods destroyed by fire. Moving on to the next transaction. The next transaction is January 28. Loan taken from bank, rupees 30,000. So I am taking loan from bank, which means this is a cash transaction, and hence it will be entered into the cash book. The journal proper will not be affected. Moving on to the last entry, January 31st, salary paid by check, rupees 12,500. So I am paying salary by check. Again, this is a cash transaction and it is to be entered into the cash book. No entry is to be passed in the journal proper. With that, we have come to the end of the sum. Let us take the total. So the total comes to 20,500. With that, we have come to the end of the sum. We have come to the end of the chapter journal proper, and we have come to the end of the series of subsidiary books. If you have liked my method of teaching, then please give this video a like, share this video, subscribe to my channel and hit the notification bell so that you never miss a new upload. I upload videos every Wednesday and Sunday. If you have any doubts, suggestions, queries, then you are free to use the comment section down below. If you want to hire me for in-depth knowledge and for my freelance services, you can contact me on my social media links. All the links are given in the description box down below, and you can also find an iCard over here which will lead you to my social media links. See you in my next video. Till then, this is Professor Tanmay Kesarkar signing off. Good luck and take care.